Today we are going to talk about a workflow that you can use to create realistic 3D materials in Rhino using Substance software. You will learn how to create many different procedural materials with a couple of sliders and how to implement these materials in your Rhino scenes. Let's get started. Hey guys, Dushan here. Before we start, if this is your first time here, I'd like to invite you to subscribe to our channel as we upload new tutorials each week on Rhino and Grasshopper and how to use these tools specifically for architecture. So you might be wondering, what is Substance and why should we, as Rhino users, care about it? Well, simply put, Substance is the industry standard software for creating realistic custom materials, both procedural and scan materials. This software gives you full control over the tiling of your textures and patterns in an easy, straightforward way, and you'll be able to just, you know, move sliders and get new materials each time. That's why procedural materials are really important, as they save time, and the best thing is that they just became available for Rhino users. Your first step would be to click on Try for Free button on this page and download Substance software. It consists of a couple of different applications called Substance Painter, Substance Designer, Substance Alchemist, and Substance Source. In this tutorial, we're going to use Substance Source and Substance Alchemist. This is where we're going to create our custom realistic materials. Alright, so now let's explore a little bit Substance Source. Let's see what kind of materials we can find here. So you can see we have a lot of different, you know, tiling materials, marble materials, and the cool thing about this is that with just a single material you can get a lot of different patterns as well. So what does this mean? For example, if I click on any of these, let's say this one, you will see that this is just one pattern that is available. And so you can see that, for example, you have preset number one, number two, number three, and you can get all of these materials from this one single procedural material. And all you need to do is download it, and then we'll be using it in Substance Alchemist later on to modify it. So now let's explore some other options that we want. So for example, I'm going to, you can check out here, you have, you know, metal, you have leather, you have plaster, you have a lot of different options. However, not all of these are free. So if you just want to use the free materials, you can go here on the top that says free assets. And this is where you'll find all of the materials that are available to download for free. And for example, let's download this one. I'm gonna download this one, and I'm gonna download, let's say, these two. This one. Okay, so now I have them all downloaded, and you can see which options I have. Afterwards, we even have some lava material. That's cool, cool to play with. And maybe rust. Yeah, let's download the rust and maybe the raw gray concrete. Now, once I have them all downloaded, you can see on the top that they're getting downloaded, then we're gonna go to Substance Alchemist. This is a separate software that comes with Substance Source. And in this case, I have it running, so I'm gonna open it now. And this is the page that you will get. So you see here that I have a lot of different materials. This is the base materials that you have available that you can use to create your own materials and modify them. So in this case, you have a clean steel material, and you can orbit around, you can see how it looks. And then even if you want to, you know, modify it, you can, for example, just move these sliders like this, and you will see how the material will change. So you can see if I'm increasing the scratches density, the dots density, you can see how this material will become different. Here you can set up the roughness of the material to see if you want it to be completely shiny or a little bit more matte, and you can modify all of that. Then you have some technical parameters, and here, for example, you can change the height, you can change the height position, and so on. So all of these options are unique for each individual material. All right, so now you can take a look at here. You will see that I have those three materials that I just downloaded, and they're located here. And now we're gonna play around with it, and then we're gonna see what we can export. Also, I'm gonna maybe use some of these wood materials. So let's say wood ash material here. And now let's see how this goes. You see here on the top, on the right side, you have something like a layering system like you would have in Photoshop. So you can just click there and delete the layer. And now you have like a blank slot, a blank material. So the first thing that you want to do, let's first create maybe some wood material. I'm simply gonna drag and drop it here. And you can see what I have to start working with. Here you also have shadows, so maybe you want to disable shadows for some materials, because you can see some have some kind of visual bugs there. Okay, so this is the default settings, and you can see here we have additional
technical parameters, which are quite different than the ones that we had previously for the steel. So in this case, for example, I can change the veins contrast here. You can see how they're getting more, you know, more pronounced. I can change the knots amount. You can have less knots if I wish. I can also switch the orientation. This is the contrast. I can also change the height range, the height position, and so on. But a cool thing is also that here I can change the color. So if I want this to be a little bit darker. And one last thing is I can change the random seed. So if I just click there, you will see that I'm gonna get different results, which is quite cool. So for example, let's say that I want to get this material into my Rhino scene. All I need to do is come here and click on export. And I'm gonna click on export current view. And now this is the important one. You want to specify a folder where you want to export this material, and then you want to name it, of course. So in this case, we're gonna name it wood one. So since this is a procedural material, it means that it's gonna save all of the maps or channels that we have associated with it with the current view that we exported. So this is where you set up all of the maps, and also this is the resolution of those maps. Usually 2K is more than enough. And then we're gonna simply click on export, and this is going to export our current view. You can see that it says exporting the maps, and now we're gonna create a couple of different variants of the same wood material, and then okay, so now I exported three different views of this same material, and you can see them in my folder here. So I have wood 1, 2, and 3, and I'm going to do the same with these three materials. So for example, I'll just drag and drop this guy here, and I'm going to delete the wood layer, and now I'm gonna play around with this material. I'm gonna, you know, adjust the color. For example, this is where you would change the color. This is where I would change the roughness to see if it's matte or shiny. And then also I would change some technical parameters. So now I'm gonna export three of these, and then I'm gonna do the same with raw gray concrete. And now let's see how do we deal with these materials in Rhino. So the first thing that you need to do, you need to type package manager, and this will open up our package manager from where we can install the plugin that we need to import these materials. So here, all you need to do is type substance, and you will see that there is a substance important plugin. Just click there and install it. I have it already installed, and now let's see how it works. So from this point on, you need to click on materials tab here. If you don't see it, right click, and then you will be able to select materials here. And then just go to the plus sign and click here, import from material library. Once you click there, we'll open up all of these materials that we just created and click on open. And now let's wait for a couple of seconds for these guys to load. Once you get this window, just click OK. And now all of the materials are going to be imported in our Rhino file. Okay, so now all of the materials are loaded, and you can see here all of the materials that we have available. So we have our concrete, our wood material, our rust material, and our colors, acrylic colors. Okay, so now once we have all of our maps loaded, let's apply them correctly. So I'm going to pick, for example, this floor. I'm gonna select my first floor material. I'm gonna say cell assign to objects, and I'm gonna do the same thing here for this one, and I'm gonna do the same thing here for this one. So this way you can see that we have three different materials based on the same procedural map. Same thing goes here if you put, for example, these materials on the walls. So I'm gonna do it here, here, and also here. So now you can see how we have three maps, three materials made from a single source material. And the same thing would apply if you do the rust and if you do the concrete. So in this case, let's do the concrete here. So you can see here the difference in the map. And the cool thing about this is that these guys are gonna work with V-Ray, they're gonna work with Enscape. So now let's try and let's see how these guys would render out in Enscape and how they would render in V-Ray. All right, so here is the result from the Enscape. You can see how our materials look really cool here in Enscape. And let's do the same thing in V-Ray, just to make sure that it works there as well. All right, so here it is. You can see that our materials are working directly in V-Ray as well. Here we have V-Ray Interactive turned on, so you can see that the quality of these materials and textures is quite high. That's the result that you can get from substance materials. In the extended version of this tutorial, which is available on our Patreon page, I'm going to show you a couple of tricks on how to create composite materials that are made out of a couple of different basic materials. And also, if you join our Patreon page, you'll get access to all of our extended tutorials and project files. The link is in the description.
I'd like to thank all of our existing Patreon supporters. Thanks to you, we can create better and more high quality content for all architects around the world. Thank you guys one more time.
If you'd like a structured step-by-step approach in learning Rhino and Grasshopper, organic and parametric architecture, presentation and rendering, you can apply for our Rhino for Architects 2.0 course. The first link in the description.